Hello students, good morning you everyone. This is Priya, your English teacher from Alpha Group of Institutions. And today we are going to discuss ACE grammar book. That is the grammar book you all know, right children? So in ACE grammar book, chapter 6, conditionals, we are going to discuss today. So open page number 51 in your ACE grammar book, that is conditionals. Okay, open now. Now look here. One second, guys. Read this sentence. Rice grows well here if there is enough water. If I cannot meet you, I will call you before I leave the city. If I had been present, I would have known about the quiz competition. If I had gone to the grocery store, they would have bought some flour. Here some fonts are in blue color, right children? Why it is in blue color? Because here we are going to talk about conditionals. So the words which carries the conditionals, we have to identify it separately. That is why we had type some fonts in blue color. And before entering into the class directly, what is conditional clause? Conditional clause, what is it children? So what are conditionals in English grammar? Can anyone say? Conditionals means, sometimes we call them as if clauses. Conditional clauses are also called as if clauses. And they describe the result. They describe the result of something that might happen in the present or future. Or something that might have happened in the past. Might have happened but didn't. Maybe we can take it as consider as it is in the past. And these conditionals are made using different verb tenses. Okay, let us see what are those. The words in bold are conditional clauses. The words in the bold are conditional clauses. And conditional clauses are a type of adverbial clauses. They express conditions. They are subordinate or dependent adverbial clauses of condition. They are also known as if clauses because we frequently use if to express a condition. If it is sunny tomorrow, we will go for a picnic. So it means conditional sentences, these are the statements. Conditional sentences are the statements discussing about like known factors. If we want to talk about the fact which is known, we use these conditional statements. And these are the statements which we discuss about known factors or hypothetical situations. Hypothetical situations and their consequences. Okay. And then, yes, complete conditional sentences contain a conditional clauses, often referred to as if clause. The conditional clause always starts with if. That is why we call it as conditional clause or if clause. And the consequences. So there are four types of conditional clauses, children. And it's important. It is really very important to use conditional clause. And it is important to use the correct structure. It is really important to use what? The right structure for each of these conditional sentences because they express varying meanings. They express varying meanings. And we have to pay attention to verb tense when using different conditional clauses. Okay? According to the modes. Then next one is, yes, we have to use a comma after the if clause when the if clause precedes the main clause. We have to use a comma because If the if clause is playing a main role in the sentence, we have to break that with a comma. Then only we can write the result what had happened. So when we are starting with an if, then definitely there will be a result. If it rains in the morning, what will happen? If it rains in the morning, I will not go to school. Okay. So if, when we are using if to talk about a sentence, to state a sentence, the following sentence will be the result. If something happens, what will be the result? If something is going to happen, what will happen? If that had happened that day, what would have happened? So whatever we use if in the main clause, it may be in the past or present or in the future, we have to break it with a comma and write the result formation, what will or may or might have happened. So these are the things about the conditional, children. And the next one, we have to talk about the zero conditionals. Okay.
Zero conditionals. Zero conditionals. Read these sentences. If I do not sleep on time, my head aches. It means if he do not sleep on time, his head aches. Ask Mini to guide you if you don't know the way. Ask Mini to guide you the way if you don't know the way. We use the zero conditional if clause to show that something will definitely result because of something else. It means we use zero conditional clause, if clause, where to show that something will definitely happen when, because of something. Here what we told, if you do not do this, this will not happen. So we are talking about a result. If something has not happened, so the result will be like this. But in zero conditionals, what will happen? The result comes first. The action comes back. There the action, if you do not, in normal if clauses, if you do not do this action, the result will be like this. If you cannot meet, if I cannot meet you, I will call you before I leave the city. But here the result comes. If like to show something, definitely this result will happen if you don't do this because of these things. We use it for general truths when an event always occurs and when something is considered standard practice. And this table shows us the forms of the verbs in the zero conditional. Verbs in if clause, verb in main clause. Present tense comes in if clause, present tense comes in main clause also. If present tense comes in if clause, then here imperative sentence. Now listen, children, zero. The so-called zero conditionals, the zero conditional if clause, like we use this zero conditional clause when the result of the condition is always true. When the result is always true, when the result is always damn fact, nobody can change the truth, or if it is like a scientific fact, then we use zero conditional only. If there is a possibility, it may happen, it may not happen. If there is only possibility or probability, we can use first or second, all those things. But zero conditional is used only if the result is a damn fact one. If the result is always true, like a scientific fact, like scientific truth, then we use zero conditionals. Like take some mice, put it in a saucepan. Heat the saucepan, what happens? The ice melts and becomes water. But we know that it is a scientific, in whatever place or country or state, if you melt the ice, it becomes water only, right? This is a scientific fact. So here we use the zero conditional. So if you heat ice, what happens? The result is it melts. That is what we are going to talk about, the zero conditionals. and if plus present simple, if like all these things we have to use, we have to be cautious about the zero conditionals. Okay children, and based on these zero conditionals we have to do the exercise now. Exercise is complete the sentence with suitable verbs. In this we have to just write the verb. What is the verb? Verb is an action verb, whether it is a main verb or an auxiliary verb. Main verb means action words like writing, sitting, standing, jumping, playing, singing, talking, all this comes under main verbs. Auxiliary verbs means what? Helping words like is, are, they, have, do, did, all this comes under auxiliary verbs. Whatever the thing is which suits the sentence here, we have to use any sort of main verb or auxiliary verbs. If no one drives you to the station, take a bus to the Howrah station. Drives is a verb here. It is easier to do that if you dash some practice. So it will be very easier to do when if you have some practice. So the answer is have. It is easier to do that if you have some practice. Okay. Mother gets annoyed if I do not dash my room. It means when does the mother get angry when as by seeing the room when we keep it dirty. So in order to avoid mother's anger, what we have to do? We have to clean the room. So what will be the answer here? Mother gets annoyed if I do not clean my room. So here the verb is clean, C-L-E-A-N. Mother gets annoyed if I do not clean my room. Plants die if they dash watered. Watered, when we water plants live. But here we are talking like plants die. So what, when we are not doing what, plants die? Plants die if they are, plants means plural, we are adding yes. So here the verb is are. Plants die if they are watered. If they are watered, will plants die? No, isn't it? So if they are not watered, so the answer is A-R-E-R-N-O-T, not. Plants die if they are not watered. Okay children, now check the answers again. Second one is, it is easier to do that if you have some practice. Mother gets annoyed if I do not clean my room. Plants die if they do not, if they are not watered. So there are six questions in this Roman children. The first four I have exercised for you and the remaining two you have to do as a homework. Okay, now next thing.
The first conditional. Read these sentences. If Samir is free, he will join us for dinner. You should reach Jamuna banquets if you continue straight on this route. We use the first conditional or type 1 if clause to talk about a situation that is likely to happen. It expresses an open condition or possibility. We use it to give permissions, commands, and advice and to denote ability. It is used for things that are likely to occur. Children, if you see the red fonts here, if Samir is free, he will join us for dinner. So here it is indicating, representing the way of possibility. If he is free, if Samir is free, there is a possibility of joining for dinner. If he is not free, he will not join for dinner. Is it so? So here we are talking about the possibility, whether if it happens. So this comes under first conditional. First conditional is also called as type 1 if clause. For zero conditional, we called it as, zero conditional is called as what? If clauses. In the same way, The first conditional is also called as type 1 if clause. So where we will use type 1 if clause? The type 1 if clause is used to talk about a situation which is going to happen, which is like about to happen. There we use type 1 if clause. And what does this type 1 if clause expresses? What does the first conditional express? It expresses an open condition or possibility. It means we use this to give permissions, commands and advice or to denote one's ability. And when we are talking about the future, children, when we are talking about the future, we use this first conditional. For example, for real possibility. If there is a possibility, if we have a real possibility, of course, we use the first conditional. We are talking about the future. We are thinking about a particular condition or situation in the future and the result of this condition also. And there is a real possibility that this condition will sure happen if that happens. So for example, it is morning, you are at home, you plan to play tennis this afternoon, but there are some clouds in the sky. So imagine that rain, if it rains, what will you do? If it rains, I will not go to play. If it don't rain, I will go for playing tennis. So this is how. This table shows us the forms of the verbs in the first conditional. So verbs in if clause, verb in main clause. Now look, if there is a present tense in if clause, what will be the answer? Will plus bare infinitive. And present tense or past continuous tense, what will come? Modal verbs or imperatives. And now here is the exercise part. And the exercise part is, rearrange the words in the brackets to complete these sentences. So as we have discussed about the first conditional, we have to do the exercise regarding it. So what is the first conditional again? The first conditional has the present simple after if. The present simple tense will be, it will be like, the it starts after if. The present simple tense will comes after if, then the future simple in the other clause. It means in the first sentence, the present simple tense will start and after if, we have to add if clause and then present simple tense. And in the second clause, what we will use? In the other clause, we will use future simple tense and what the other words, like infinitive. If, look for example, first one, if Priya sings well, what will happen? If is an if clause, Priya sings well, S-I-N-G-S, sings well is a present simple tense. Then what will happen in future tense? She will win the competition. This is an infinitive. Infinitive means we can add something which will be resulting the first clause. If Priya sings well, she will win the competition. So if clause and then simple present tense. The other clause, what happens? Will plus infinitive. Okay. If it is sunny, so okay, wait, let us discuss first about this. Like this first conditional is used to talk about the things which might happen in the future. So the first conditional means we are going to talk about what all the things going to happen in the future, which is likely to happen in the future. And of course, we can't know what will happen in the future, but this describes the possible things which could easily come true. It means in this first conditional, we will talk what is going to happen in the future. But we are not exact. We are not going to say about the perfect. Because in zero conditional, we spoke that, we have discussed that The scientific fact and only the general truths will be discussed under the zero conditional. But here in the first conditional, we are going to talk about the future, like in future what will happen. It means we don't know what will happen exactly, but we will be discussing about the possibility of happening. It means it may happen, it will happen, it may not also be happen, right? But with possibility we use this first conditional. But this describes the possible things which could easily come true. So if, for example, morning when we are seeing it is cloudy, we are not 100% sure it will rain, but 95% we are sure that it will rain, right? So to a certain concern we know that it will rain to the 90 to 99%, 1% it may not. So there is a possibility of rain by seeing the black clouds. That is talking about the possibility in the future. So this first conditional is used to talk about the things which might, not which will compulsorily happen, which might happen in the future. And here we don't know exactly what will happen in the future, but we can speak about the possibility what could happen, what could become true. When we had discussed about this, let us do the exercises according to this. If it is sunny tomorrow, what will happen? If it is sunny tomorrow morning, what will happen? Don't forget, we have to start with will, okay? We have to talk in the future tense. What will, if it is sunny tomorrow, we will play football. So you have to rearrange the words which are given in the brackets and make it into a sentence. In the textbook, children, you will not have any place to write the second other clause, the remaining answer. The result you can't write. So do one thing. Write number on this. For example, if it is sunny tomorrow morning, what is the first word? We. Here you write 1. We will. Write 2 here, will. Then play. 3. Football, 4. We will play football. So you can number it and then it will be very easy for you to read. Third one. If you do not study hard, what will happen? We have to start with will, right? You will not do, then do well, and then in later what will come? The exams. Now did you number, children? If you do not study hard, what will happen? You will not do well in the exams. Now write, you is 1, will 2, not 3, do 4, well 5, in 6, 7 is the, sorry, 5 is in, 6 is the, 7 is exams. Did you finish numbering? Now, 8th one. We will cancel our trip to the Japanese garden. We will cancel our trip to the Japanese garden if it rains on Sunday. So we will cancel our trip to the Japanese garden if it rains on Sunday. Now check the answer, children. The first one they have given, if Priya sings well, she will win the competition. If it is sunny tomorrow morning, we will play football. If you do not study hard, you will not do well in the exams. We will cancel our trip to the Japanese garden if it rains on Sunday. So there are 7 questions in this exercise B Roman in page number 52 and 53. I have done 4 for you. The remaining 3 you do it. Like you just number, no need to write, because you don't have place to write the whole sentence in examination. You can write the sentence, but here you can just put the numbers. Okay, children. Yes, now coming to the second conditional. The second conditional. This is also called as type 2 clause. Type 2 conditional. We can call it as type 2 conditional clause, type 2 if clause, or the second conditional. First one is zero conditional. Second one is first conditional or type 1 conditional or type 1 if clause. The second conditional is also called as type 2 if clause or type 2 conditional. Read these sentences. She would try to help her friend if she knew the truth. She would try to help her friend if she knew the truth. If I had an umbrella, I would not get wet. Now listen to the explanation, guys. We use the second conditional or type 2 if clause to talk about a situation that is unlikely to happen or imaginary. It means we use the second conditional clause for what? To talk about the situation that is unlikely to happen. It means that when we are not sure about the things, when we are talking something which is not going to happen, which will not happen, when we are going to talk about giving the word about that, like imaginary things, we use second conditional. The past tense in the type 2 if clause expresses an unreal or improbable condition. It is unlikely that it will be fulfilled. So this type 2 if clause expresses what? Which is not real, which is imaginary, which is not possible, which may not happen. We will talk about that only in the second conditional clause. Okay. Now here, in the second conditional, in this type 2 conditional sentence, the tense in the if clauses is in the past tense. The tense in the if clause is in the past tense, and the tense in the main clause is in the present conditional or the present continuous conditional. Would plus bare infinitive. Now, as in all conditional sentences, children, the order of the clauses is not fixed. In all the conditions, the order is never fixed. And we have to reorder these, all these punctuations, pronouns, whatever it may be, to make it a proper sentence. We have to reorder. It will not be exact. We have to keep commas. We have to change the order. We have to do the work. And when you change the order of the clause, but the meaning should be identical. Whenever we are changing the order, like punctuations, the pronouns and everything, or we are adding or removing also, the meaning should be reasonable. The meaning should be identical. And the type 2 conditional refers to an unlikely or hypothetical condition and its probable result. So when you are talking about something which is not going to happen, which is not real, the result will be what? It will be the probable result. And these sentences are not based on the actual situation. These are not talking about the truth. These are not talking about the facts. In type 2 conditional sentence, the time is now, like, or any time, and the situation is hypothetical. And this is correct, that very common to say, if I were, instead of if I was. We have changing that was or were according to the singular and plural. And in this type 2 conditional, you can also use modals in the main clause. Look, when it is a past continuous tense or past tense, here we are using the modals could, would, might along with the bare infinitive. So we can use the modals along with the infinitive in the main clause only to express the degree of certainty, like to, if you want to express the permission or request, or if you want to recommend about something which is going to happen, we can use this could or would. Maximum we will use would only, and then sometimes could and might also. Okay, did you understand what is the second conditional, children? So this is what about, we have finished discussing about the first conditional. So simply to say in form, the second condition is for unreal possibility. When we are talking about the zero conditional, we are talking about the general fact, scientific fact. When we are talking about the first condition, the first conditionals are used only for the real possibility which is going to happen, which is likely to happen. But in the second conditional, we use this for which is not unreal, which is unlikely to happen. The second conditional is like the first conditional only. We are still thinking about the future. We are thinking about the future in both the first conditional and second conditional. But the difference is there, the real possibility, and here the unreal possibilities. And we are thinking about a particular condition in the future and the result of this condition. But there is not a real possibility that this condition will happen. So, like, you can think about winning in the future like a dream. It's not. Let us discuss along with the exercise partner. Okay, guys. Look. See. Match the clauses in columns A and B to form complete sentences. So, in page number 53, you can see the match the following. In this match also, I did not give you everything. I just wrote only something. If I were in Hyderabad, if I were in Hyderabad, I would be with my family. Here I am not telling that I will be. I am not giving the guarantee here. I am just giving the possibility. If I am not there, I will not be there, right? If I were there, I would be. Here the bare infinitive is there, but we are not giving any confirmation about the fact. So if I were in Hyderabad, I would be with my family. If he had her address, he would send her a gift. Second one, what is the answer? If he had her address, he would send her a gift. Now coming to the third one, I would go to the cinema. I would go to the cinema if I had some company. The third answer is, if I would go to the cinema, I would go to the cinema if I had some company. Fourth one is, if it were summer. The answer is in the G, we would play outdoors. So like this, you have to match the right form of the verb if clause and the main clause tables. Okay, children, you have to do the exercise. So your today's exercise is, whatever we had discussed from the first page, you have to do the remaining exercises. Okay, guys. So let us end this session with this. And in next session, let us discuss about the recollection of what all we have learned in the conditional chapter, and then along with that we are going to discuss the third conditional also. So today we have discussed zero conditional. What are the conditionals? Zero conditionals, the first conditional and the second conditionals, right? And your homework for today is page number 52. In page number 52, A Roman and B Roman. And page number 53, continuation of B Roman and C Roman. These are the homework for you today. And thank you, guys. Let me end this session with this. Thank you for staying with me. Please kindly obey your teachers and your parents. and be safe at home. Okay. Thank you. This is Priya signing off from Alpha Group of Institutions. Bye.